This event is about transforming HR.
What skills, or what do we recommend HR, is that important to be able to do this and act innovatively and creatively? So a lot of people talk about STEM. Obviously STEM is really important. People have kids, everything's STEM now. And we think STEM is important, but it's often what you need to do to add to that. So we often talk about ADDS. So ADDS. So A is agile, and Enrique was talking about small A agile, so I talk big A agile, which that is, there's a methodology originally came out of software. It's now the principles adopted from Spotify to GE and a lot of different companies. And it's really a way of working in a chaotic, uncertain environment, which is almost everybody's environment. Like, how do we do this at a cross-functional team and work in this new way? That's not top-down, but much more collaborative. And this particularly for managers, but I see in HR is really challenging because it's a whole new way of doing organizational structure.
We talk about technology, what's going to be happening with AI, machine learning. What we don't talk about as often is how demographic shifts are also going to be disruptive and how they're going to influence the future of work. And what's very interesting is right now we have 5 generations working side by side in the workforce, but we really haven't reorganized the way we work for about a century. So we're doing things in the same old way, even though we know we're having these shifts. So our challenge is, how do we re-engineer work? How do we be more intentionally inclusive to make sure that we're appealing to Gen Z?
The way that we have been accustomed to having experiences in life and how we've been moving, we demand and expect a certain type of experience when it comes to even how we learn at work.
Yeah, we're using some of the most advanced forms of science to do things like tell us what movie we should watch when we go home at night. And Netflix has done amazing things in that space. Amazon tells me what I want to buy before I even know I'm shopping for it, right? But talent is our most valuable resource. Yet we're still relying on science that was developed largely in the 70s to do something as important as hire our people.
Currently, it's estimated that there are only 5,000 blockchain developers in the world. Just Airbus, they're going to move their entire supply chain on the blockchain. They need 15,000 just for them. The financial sector is looking for 250,000 people, developers. This isn't just your user interface developers. This isn't your back-end developers. These are actually the core blockchain developers. This is what they're going to be needing. We're going to be needing hardcore blockchain developers, 250,000. I started this by telling you there's a coming war for talent. Your job as HR is to actually find this talent. Your job as HR is also to advise your line managers that they're going to have to be looking at something a little bit more quickly than what they are doing right now. A lot of them have already gotten into little teams that are doing proof of concepts, and they've been playing around with this for the last 2 years, but little teams do not do enterprise rollouts. They never, ever will. There's just not enough people. So your job is going to be to actually try to hire these people who are going to have these skills. And remember, we're only at 5,000 today. We need to be at 2.5 million.
So our research shows that there are really 2 types of companies, blue-yellow companies, which think that business strategy and their technology strategy are 2 different things. And then you have green companies who integrate their business and technology strategy.
If you don't have an ecosystem which does not appreciate experiments, it is going to be very, very hard. How many of you in your work, think about it, in HR run experiments, how many of you do like a double-blind randomized controlled trial, which is the gold standard in pharmaceuticals? How many of you do that? So when we started looking at it, it was like, you know, the model was not behaving because we were not doing, people were doing natural experiments. This is a quick example of what experiments other companies do, and there's a great article by Michael Simmons on this particular topic.